What's your moonshot? Whether you're an individual or an organization, what's that calling? What's that dream that you've got that it might seem scary, it might seem unattainable, and yet it still compels you, it still draws you every single day. Everybody has one of these. Every organization has that potential. The difference is whether or not they've actually acted on it or started moving towards it. When you talk about that sort of a compelling dream, the way to look at whether it's there or not is look at your organization, look at your life as an individual. At the end of the day, a typical day, do you go and look at it and go, maybe you're tired, but you go, wow, that you've really felt good, that you got somewhere. Or do you just look back exhausted and go, meh, it was just another day of busyness. Which is it that you choose? The difference is whether or not you've defined, you've explored what that calling is within you, and you've decided to make that movement to it. The difference is whether you've stated, this is what I'm about, this is where I'm going for, this is my moonshot.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal before this decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the earth. No single space project in this period will be more impressive to mankind or more important for the long-range exploration of space.
When Kennedy made that statement, it was impossible to do what he asked for. We just didn't have the technology. Also, when people think about it, they think of it in terms of the mission. It is about getting a man on the moon and before the Russians. So that was something tangible. However, behind it was a purpose to inspire a country to go beyond. In fact, to inspire humanity to go beyond what they had thought was possible until now. And it's the purpose that has the real power, not the mission. When Kennedy declared that they were going for the moon, their technology was nowhere near what was needed. They were like way down here. And what happened over the years, once he said, we are going for that before the end of the decade, what happened is slowly they made advancements. There was a huge amount of resources that went into it, increased slowly, and it was only near the end that things really came together in terms of what they needed to do and to actually make it happen, to realize that dream. Now, in that case, the what was a huge part of it, getting to the moon, okay? The thing I've discovered in working with individuals and working with organizations is that the what isn't nearly as important as the why. And I'll illustrate that with my own story. In my case, it was very similar. I wanted to go for the moon. I wanted to be an astronaut. And that was my dream when I was a kid. So what I did was I went into the sciences. I got a couple of physics degrees. And I thought, if I'm not working as a scientist, I am going to work for NASA and do all of these things. So I was basically working along, and I did my work for my moonshot, and went and got my degree, but a lot of stuff happened around there. And what I discovered was that my passion was not necessarily the technology. My passion, the complexity that I learned in quantum physics, was a huge part of what's important to me, is that I learned how to simplify complexity. But my passion is people. And people are far more complex and fascinating than quantum physics. I changed my moonshot. The why didn't change. The why was this whole idea of creating. I'm a creator, and I wanted to create new possibilities as I was going into space and so on and so forth. So what happened is I discovered that my moonshot was, the why was the same, but how I was going to express it was different. So I created a whole new target that was very different. I went back, got some business training, learned how to work with people, work with change, how to coach, and so on and so forth, and how to realize potential. And so I changed my tracks so that even though I started out with that, and that complexity actually helps me in my work, the what changed expression in that instead of going to the moon, I am working with people, with organizations to help them unlock their potential. And that's the why was the same about creating new ways and exploring and discovering. But it's not about exploring the universe, it's about exploring people. So that was the why, the purpose. Now, for a lot of people, they don't know their purpose. That's the truth. And what's surprising is that the opposite of purpose, or the lack of purpose, is not what you would think of sort of a malaise or lack of activity. The opposite of purpose is busyness. People who have that emptiness, who don't have that knowing of why they are, they create busyness in their lives. And same with organizations. If they don't have a clear why, if they're just doing a what, they become workaholic cultures that are just plain busy. And you just, you know, you're going, and people feel important because they have so many emails, because they're so much in demand, because they're in so many meetings, they always have to run in late and leave early. Now, let me be clear. Just because you're busy and running around late to every meeting because you've had another meeting right before it and are swamped by emails does not mean that you're important. It's just a cover, in my mind, for that lack of purpose. People I know who are on purpose, they can be busy, but they have focus and they understand what to say no to. Organizations that have a shared purpose, that really understand why they're doing what they're doing, have leaders that know who's responsible for what. They've delegated things. They don't need to be inundated by all of those emails. So yeah, people are busy, but they're not crazy busy, and things happen a lot more effectively. So what happens if you keep going and keep going? In our environment, things are changing now. You can't just keep doing things the same way. Things are changing faster and faster. So what's the inevitable outcome if you follow that route of busyness? Well, there's a perfectly clear example that's apparent right now. Whether you're an individual who surrendered their power to an organization to create their future, or whether you're an organization that didn't look around at what was happening in the world to see where you could go, how you could make a difference strategically, this is your perfect example of what's going to happen if you follow that pursuit of busyness. So does that mean that your life's going to be a disaster or your company's going to be a wreck if you're not on purpose? No, of course not. But what it does mean is that you are going to be a lot more at risk if you're not taking control of your destiny, whether it's personally or corporately. Now, not having a purpose doesn't mean your life's bad or the company is bad. It just means it's a lot more meh. And it's on a personal level, are you wanting to live life that way? On a corporate level, do you want to deal with that level of disengagement, which is epidemic these days? So, for example, I could have, as I said, I started out with my moonshot, but then staying on purpose, I found that the what changed, but the why stayed the same. I could have chosen not to do that and gone a totally different direction where I might have had a very good life, I could have had a very okay life and whatever, and I could have wished, been wishing for that I had gone for my moonshot, that I had gone for that. And the thing is, I could have been successful by a lot of counts, but what I'm encountering a lot now is people that have got all the bells and whistles, but they look back and they just go, so what? Or organizations that, they're productive, but people go, so what? What's the difference that I'm making in the world? And there's no sense of engagement or commitment in that. And as I said, the real test is everyone has good days and bad days. But on the average, are more of your days, that I'm excited about what I'm creating? Or are they looking at the day and go, meh, whatever, it happened, and I'm looking forward to my next getaway? That's the choice you have every single day. If you have not yet discovered and lived on purpose, personally, corporately. You can start that journey any day. But that's the choice. Do you go for yeah or do you go for meh?